And then on top of that, I bought her a car. I got her a car.
Alright, you know what? You know what? I'm actually sick of y'all. This the same kid that you was out here dragging on the internet talking about she's sucking dick at 14, 15. She in the 8th grade. You bought her a car? This is why you parents are nuts. This is why your kids don't take you serious. This is why I make these videos. You guys are hypocrites. You guys are crazy. Oh my God. Yo, help me. Help me. Help my future kids. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help my man. Help me never be a parent like this ever in my life. You bought her a car after you dragged her like that? Wow, 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 wow. I'm gonna have high blood pressure by the time I hit 1 million subscribers on this channel. Please don't tell me I just heard what I heard, y'all. Please don't tell me I just heard what I heard. Everybody, hi, I'm D Mademoiselle, and I should close this laptop. Hold on 2 seconds. Let's. What up, everybody? I am D Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we actually have an update from one of the reactions that I did of a mother embarrassing their child on the internet for being bad. Now, I will link down the original video down below if I could find it, because I just spent like a good 30 minutes trying to find a video and I couldn't. By the time this video is out, hopefully I can find it. But apparently, this child did run away after this whole situation. So the reason I really wanted to react to this is because a lot of times I do these videos, a lot of these parents, right, will come on here like, oh, you guys are so sensitive. This generation just doesn't like repercussions. You guys think that everything is a problem. You guys are always hoopling, hollering, and crying about nonsense. This is not gonna do any harm to these kids. But now we have a child that was embarrassed on the internet and they've run away. So I'd love to hear, parents of the year, what do you guys think about this? And of course, everyone else, if you have seen this video already, what do you guys think about this? I believe this video I'm going to react to is going to have the new and the old content, but just in case, it's going to be linked down below for you guys. So get your tea, get your snacks, get everything you need, because this is going to be a pretty difficult one.
Please my ass, you wasn't pleasing. Motherfucking goddamn, you wasn't pleasing. No. No, 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 right here. How old are you? How old are you? How old are you? You're 14, right? You had sex how many times?
One.
Okay, you sucking dick?
No.
You sucking dick?
No.
Do your mom even let you do all this bullshit? Say goodbye to your followers.
Goodbye.
I will not have a phone. I would not have Instagram.
I have Instagram.
All right, now, personally, I remember this girl, okay? I do remember this girl, and it was definitely one of the most infuriating videos to watch. I never followed up with the story because, honestly, it is kind of hard to keep up with these stories. There are so many updates a lot of the time. Sometimes these parents don't say anything. Sometimes they see the comments. They just start going off, and I just don't be caring to hear about the parents. I really only care about the kids, to be quite honest, because you sat here, you put your child on the internet for clout, for validation, as punishment, whatever the case may be. I don't care about what you have to say about it at that point, because what are you going to say? You're just gonna say that you did what you need to do, that your child, you can do what you want with them. Like, what do I really need to hear, right? But in this case, since this child ran away, it mind boggles me that anyone could ever say that this type of punishment makes sense at all, because it just doesn't. Like, it never will.
I'm sitting here reading all these comments and everything. I done been up and down all these streets, best friends, everything. I done called everybody, and everybody's sitting here saying this is embarrassing and you shouldn't be doing this. But if I get that knock on the door in the morning and they saying that my baby is dead, or I get that call saying I need to go to the hospital because she's been raped or she's been drugged. I get that call and say, mama, I don't know where I'm at. I've been snatched up. Then I'm embarrassing. This is wrong. All this is wrong. Y'all been all on social media sending me fake. People been sending me fake addresses. People been giving me fake phone numbers and calls and everything. Do y'all know y'all messing with somebody, child? Would y'all want y'all mama sitting here waiting? Because I'm sitting here waiting. Motherfuckers talking about I ain't shedding no tears and all this shit. I gotta keep it together because I have a whole other child in here.
Really don't want to be an asshole over here, but I don't want to hear it because you sat here dragging your daughter. That literally, like I said, was one of the most volatile videos that I have reacted to. You sat here exposing your daughter's sex life on the internet and she's 14 and you're confused as to why she ran away. You're confused as to why people are dragging you in the comments, and then you're confused as to why people are calling you embarrassing, and you don't want people coming at you confused as to why you're upset about why she ran away. Now, I will say straight up, right? Just because she did what she did doesn't mean she doesn't love her daughter. Doesn't mean she's a horrible parent, whatever. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying that the actions aren't matching up, right? They just aren't matching up, especially to the outside perspective. Like, I know my parents have done really fucked up shit to me that made me think that they didn't love me or they didn't like me or they resented me, whatever the case may be. But I can imagine if they did something like this to me, I'd run away too. I'm not saying the child's right for it. I'm not saying that the mother, you know, should not be, you know, making her case on the internet and trying to find her daughter. But I'm saying, like, you have to understand when you put things on the internet, this is what happens. It's as if adults don't know what the internet is and what the internet is capable of. You put something out on a public platform, expect what comes back. The internet is like a boomerang. You throw something out, things are gonna come back. Whether it's likes, whether it's comments, whether it's monetization, something is always gonna come back to you. I don't understand what you thought was going to happen. And I'm sorry if I sound a little insensitive here, but like, I'm sick and tired of these parents doing this shit. And then when something happens, when something backfires, they want people to feel bad for them. And it's not even just these parents that I react to. It's parents in real life, okay? Because I have so many parents in my life, right, that want me to deal with their kids. And then they're confused when literally the kids run away, the kids are fighting them, the kids literally move out at 18, and they're like, oh, Yvonne, I get them to move back. Bitch, no! I've been telling you to listen to your kids since they were 8. I've been telling you that your kid really wants you to spend time with them since they were 4. I've been literally trying to get you to listen for how long, and now you're confused that your kid wants to live with their aunt. Your kid wants to literally be in a homeless shelter and not want to be with you. Do you know how ridiculous it is that someone would want to be in a homeless shelter and not live with their own parents? I've seen it. I've seen it a couple of times. Okay, like, a lot of y'all need to understand that some of you guys just don't give a shit about your kids. And it's not even that you don't give a shit, you make your kids feel like you don't give a shit. That's really what it boils down to.
But all y'all sitting here making it as a joke, but it's not a joke.
It's not.
She has run away. She ran because she ran. She is running. She's a juvenile and she ran.
What?
The whole point. It doesn't mean why she ran, why she's gone, or anything else. The whole point is getting safe. Getting her safe.
Okay.
Everybody's not looking at the bigger picture.
Okay, I will say straight up, it's very petty that people are out here sending her false information, but that just goes to show they definitely know where that girl is. That girl probably had in one of her friend's house, one of her boyfriend's houses or whatever. Like, I'm sure she's fine, but let's just see.
Everybody's not looking at the bigger picture of what's going on. It's 15, she's out there, and she does not have no family here, and it's not fair. And I'm just sitting here thinking about God knows what is going to happen to my child. Since everybody said that I'm the problem, she ran away because she did not pass the high school. And she did not pass to go to high school.
What?
So she's embarrassed. So at the end of the day, I sat there and thought that had passed. So I got her an iPhone 11. Since I found out that didn't pass, that she's still in middle school, had from...
Child, this too much. Okay, so apparently the girl done ran away because she didn't pass, I guess, the 8th grade to move to the 9th grade. I don't know why she's saying pass high school. I'm like, pass what? Like the state test to leave high school? To go into college? But I guess she didn't pass the 8th grade to move on to the 9th grade. But she's 15. Why is she still in the... Am I tripping? I graduated 8th grade at 14. Started freshman year at 14. Some of you may have started at 13 if your birthday's really late. You know, like past September. I don't know why she's 15 in the 8th grade and failing. That don't make no sense. Nonetheless, okay, nonetheless, Why would you not fact check that she graduated before celebrating and getting her a phone? This is not college where kids could conceal whatever it is that they do. The report card, the delinquent records, all of that shit come to your house. The kid not in class, the kid's failing, the kid's doing the pute qua, it come to your house. They call your house. This is the shit that I be talking about. Y'all be working 12-hour shifts, worried about everything but your child. And then you're confused as to why they do certain things. You're confused as to why they act certain ways. This is why they act certain ways and they do certain things. Do you guys not understand that? It's because of the lack of attention, okay? They act out because of the lack of attention. They, especially girls, they go seek out boys when there's no fathers in the home, okay? That's one. And the lack of attention. They have nothing to do. The lack of extracurriculars. There's lots of different reasons. But right here, I need to understand how the fuck you didn't know your kid ain't pass a grade. That's what I, yo, and I'm, oh man, I'm not even trying to be petty and saying like all of this is her fault, because I don't think all of it is her fault. But like, don't make it seem like you ain't got a part to play in this, mother, because you do.
So everything that she is saying, everything that she is around here putting on and everything, this is why left, because she had an iPhone 11, but she did not pass. She did not pass.
Okay.
She's still in the middle school. And then I caught her with pictures and videos that's inappropriate. What are you talking about? This is the reason why she's leaving. The reason why she is leaving, because guys are in her inbox and she wants to fondle around and she wants to be for the cloud, because y'all are so judgmental. She'd rather be disrespectful to her mother that gives her everything, because I give her everything.
Y'all need to understand where this shit comes from. Girls don't just go around fucking and sucking little boys for fun and just for the validation of it all. It really comes from, one, where's my dad? Two, where's my mom? Three, I don't have shit to do. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get on this phone, I'm gonna get the attention where I'm not getting it from. It's 1, 2, 3, very, very simple. I've never seen it happen any other way. Girls are not just born thoughts, okay? They're not, contrary to popular belief, okay? Just because we have a vagina doesn't mean we want something to fill it all the damn time. Sorry to be vulgar, but that's just the truth. If you keep a child engaged, if you keep a child interested, if you give the child attention, care, love, and dedication, they will more than likely not stray too far away. Yeah, they're gonna have little boyfriends. Yeah, they're gonna talk back. Yeah, they're gonna have a little attitude, but they're not gonna be searching for things that don't fulfill them if they're fulfilled in other ways that are healthy. It's all about healthy fulfillment. I work with kids all the time. I'm a dance teacher. And it's interesting because the way they act towards me versus other adults, completely different. The way their behavior is, the way they respond to me, whatever, is completely different than they do with other kids. And it's the same thing with any other adult that they interact with. It's because I respect them on a completely different level. I make them make their own choices. They always look into these other adults to make choices for them. They're always yelling at them and treating them like they're children. Listen, yes, you are a child. I understand you're a child, but one day you're gonna be a big child, okay? You're gonna be a fucking adult. So make these choices. I always give them choices. I always give them options. And most importantly, I let them know that they are important. They are seen. Every time their birthday comes, I give them a little gift or whatever. Like, at the end of the day, you have to let your child know that they're seen. Yeah, you may give the child everything that they want, an iPhone, whatever, but that's not the point. When's the last time you went to the movies with the child? When's the last time you got your nails done with the child? When's the last time you just sat down to watch a Netflix show with a child? It's not just about giving gifts, okay? Like, it's not just about giving your kid whatever it is that they ask for. It's about more than that. I don't remember the last time I spent time with my parents watching TV, because every single time I go to my parents' house, they just want to sit there on fucking WhatsApp or taking naps or pissing me off about something, you know? My parents never spent time with me, you know? So that's why I'm hyper independent, and it's something I'm still working on to this day. And yeah, it's helped me in many ways, but at the same time, it's been very, very detrimental to a lot of things.
Not lack. I know y'all see her wigs. I know y'all see her nails. I know y'all seen her other phone. It went from black to an iPhone 11. But I found out was not performing in school like she's supposed to. So she got transferred over to an Android. Ran away because she got to an Android because she did not pass her class. It's whatever put putting on and telling y'all why she ran away. She's still out there putting her best friend in a situation where she lied to me and her mother.
Let me just say, that's the reason you think she ran away. I guarantee you, if somebody else asked her, it'd be something completely different that she doesn't want to talk to you about. Kids always lying. Let's just say that flat out, right? What is the appropriate age for kids to be wearing wigs? Comment down below. Why is a 14, 15 year old wearing wigs? I find that real, I don't know. Okay, like, I think natural hairstyles, I don't think that has an age limit. I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong. It might. But wigs? Why are we putting wigs on children? She could've get box braids? No? You gonna get something more cultural? We just had to slap the European on her? I don't know. I'm just saying. Like, why? Like, and again, why is she getting her nails? I started getting my nails in 15, 16. That's when I started earning my own money to get my nails done. Why this little girl don't got a job? You could get a job at 14 at certain places. Why are you just spoiling her so much? She's such a bad child. Like, there's a lot of things. A child should not have all of these things. That's another thing that a lot of y'all parents need to stop. Y'all need to stop with these PlayStation 5s. Y'all need to stop with these iPhone 12, 13, whatevers. Y'all need to stop with these lace fronts. Y'all need to stop with these chokers. Y'all need to stop with these mini skirts. Y'all need to stop with these Jordans. Why are these kids getting these high ticket items before they're even 16? Like, it's just, that's wild. I think that's a little too much. Yeah, the kid could have a smartphone, but like, $1,000 smartphones. We're joking, right? We're giving kids like $1,000 smartphones now. And I know the iPhone 11, you get very cheap now. Like, I just got my business iPhone. It's an iPhone 11. I paid $150 for that. Okay, so yeah, you could get them shits real cheap now. But you guys understand where I'm coming from, right? Like, why are we giving these kids high ticket items? And they should be focused on schoolwork. Okay, they should be focused on extracurriculars. They should be focused on being an entrepreneur if that's what they want to do. They should be focused on kid things. Not the latest iPhone, not the latest games, not the latest Jordans, not the latest lace front, not the latest nail designs. Like, it's just, it's a little far-fetched to me. If you guys understand where I'm coming from, comment down below, because I feel like I'm not getting what I need to get out properly. Like, it is a little weird. Like, I teach middle school and these kids got iPhones and I'm like, that's a little weird. Okay, like, all of them have iPhones and I'm like, what in, like, date child. And the crazy part is they don't even know how to use it properly. That's the craziest thing about it. It's like, what the hell do you, like, come on now. Like, they don't even know how to use an Android properly, let alone an iPhone. So it's just like, what happens to giving kids chirps? Okay, and then they be looking at so many crazy things on the internet and I'm like, child, if you do not give me the damn phone. Like, it's giving these kids unrestricted internet access and then you're confused as to, so what happens when you give kids unrestricted internet access? Let's be real. If you give a kid a smartphone, they're gonna be smart with it, right? They're gonna go on the internet, they're gonna get pictures, they're gonna go to social media, they're gonna do all this smart shit. That is a beautiful girl. You don't think she's getting male attention, especially if she's not getting attention at home? Yeah, you gave her wigs and you get her nails done and all of that. Are you going to the nail shop with her to get her nails done? That's what it comes down to. How much time are you spending with her?
Because she did not pass. Paris is still in the eighth grade. She did not go. She's not a freshman. She did not pass to go to the high school. So why would I reward somebody with an iPhone 11 that I've been sitting here giving everything she wants? She get lashes. She get her nails done.
Lashes?
She get everything she wants. She wanted to upgrade. I upgrade her until I found out. Failed class. She failed. She's not going to high school. She's 15 and she still got to stay in the eighth grade. So everything that she's out there saying, tell her to stop lying, because this is why she ran away. You've seen this in her pictures. This is why.
Why do we just let anyone have kids? Like, can we please just start having tests? Verification process, something. I don't even give a fuck if I'm not approved, because this is insane. So you think that your daughter ran away because she didn't pass the eighth grade and she's 15, and then you gave her a phone because you didn't know that she passed and then you took it away? You think that's why she ran away? Meanwhile, the internet is basically saying that she ran away because you dragged her and you embarrassed her. Why the hell are you putting her business out there again? You think that's gonna make her wanna come home? Wow, a lot of you guys are really not smart. Like, this is what got you into the mess in the first place. Why don't you just shut up and go to the authorities and just let them do their job? Oh my god.
Tell her class, I thought she passed, so I got her iPhone 11.
We get
to
it.
Go to school.
We get
to
it.
Upgrade herself. And then on top of that, I bought her a car.
Alright, you know what? I'm actually sick of y'all. This the same kid that you was out here dragging on the internet talking about, so she's sucking dick at 14, 15, she in the 8th grade. You bought her a car? This is why you parents are nuts. This is why your kids don't take you serious. This is why I make these videos. You guys are hypocrites. You guys are crazy. Oh my God. Yo, help me. Help me. Help my future kids. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help my man. Help me never be a parent like this ever in my life. You bought her a car after you dragged her like that? Wow, 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 wow. She can't even drive. She's not even a drive. She's not even 16.
I'm gonna have high blood pressure by the time I hit 1 million subscribers on this channel.
Wow, Munsayo, egale! Egale! Li pa possible. It's not possible. Please don't tell me I just heard what I heard, y'all. Please don't tell me I just heard what I heard. A car? How you gonna buy a car for somebody that don't got a license? I understand people love their child, they wanna spoil their child and all of that, but like, this child is clearly troubled. That's what, we can't deny that. It don't matter how much I'll take up for a child. It doesn't matter how much I'll defend a child, but I know when a child's bad as shit. Trust me, I got some badass kids on my roster. I know they're bad as shit. I do not reward their bad behavior. This is rewarding bad behavior. Come on now. See, this is why I don't take y'all serious. Whoosh.
This is why.
That's a nice Android phone.
This is why.
To be honest, now let me just say this video is old, okay? I'm talking about 2021 old, so I think it's safe to assume that the girl did return home. It's just very interesting how like these parents be that type of delusional, where they will drag their kids, belittle their kids, say all these things to their kids, but then be confused as to why their kids act certain ways or react certain ways to certain punishments. Like, it just doesn't make any logical sense to me. Like, listen, your kids are gonna act a specific type of way towards you if you allow them to, and most importantly, if they feel like they're not being given the proper attention. Of course, if they're not given the proper channels to channel whatever negative energy that they may have towards you or towards anything else, okay? And if they don't have a proper mentor or like an older sibling or something like that to vent to. Like, I don't know how hard it is for people to understand that. Now, I ain't gonna lie, this mother just don't seem that smart. I'm not even gonna lie, like, she seemed a little just, some things don't seem right up here, okay? I will say that. And it's very interesting that she really came to the internet dragging her daughter yet again. Like, not dragging, but like putting her daughter's business on the internet yet again, as if that's not something that literally put her in this mess in the first place. But of course, I would love to hear everything that you guys have to say about this video down below. What do you guys think about this? Do you guys think that Paris ran away because she failed the 8th grade? Do you guys think that she ran away because she was exposed on the internet? Or do you guys think it was something else? I feel like it could be something else, only because I have parents calling me all the time about their kids, and they will tell me one story, but the kids telling me another story. So then I have to find a way to bridge the gap and present something to the both of them so they could leave me the hell alone. I ain't about to tell the kids business, but you know, the parent is obviously concerned. So I just be telling them like, listen, this is what your kid's going through. I ain't gonna tell their business, but you should talk to them about this or bring this up so they can tell you whatever it is that's going on, you know? So it's just like, realistically, kids are never gonna tell you exactly what's going on. They're not gonna be like, oh, my boyfriend Kendrick broke up with me and he's the cutest boy in 8th grade, and like, they're not gonna tell you that stuff, right? Because not only is it embarrassing, but like, you're their parent. They're not gonna tell you stuff like that. And it may seem ridiculous to us, but it is all the world to them, okay? That's why when kids start talking, I just let them talk, okay? Like, I come in to class with my kids and they're like, yo, this girl, she got in trouble for being racist. Oh my God, this girl pushed me today. I just let them talk because I know they got a vent, because more than likely, if they're telling me about it, that means that it's something that affected them. It's something that really bothered them, or it's something that they feel like they have an opinion about. And it is important to let children express their opinions, because if not, you end up with kids like this that want to fucking suck at 14 and 15. I know that because I was one of those that lost my V-card at 15. So it is what it is. That was kind of annoying as hell to watch. Oh my God. But that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And of course, let me know down below, have you ever been embarrassed on the internet? And of course, did it teach you anything? Because obviously this girl did not learn anything. As a matter of fact, she ran away. If we're doing the math correct, this girl would be what, 17, 18 now? So I really hope she is doing well. If anyone has any other updates on any other stories or this particular story, please send them my way. Most preferably send them in the Discord, because I'll get them faster. But with that being said, like, share, subscribe, do all of that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye. Mom.